You ever just get sad at shit? My water tastes like cardboard, and I don't know why, but I don't like it. But anyway, hi! So I think if I to do this, I have to sign into network, even though this isn't part, and then I come over here, and now you'll let me play these, right? Why? Then why do you not put this in the network mode? So I came over here, and I'm like, alright, I want to show these, because look at how many replays I have saved. There's also additional matches beyond that I forgot to save in the menu, and so, like, I took clips of them, but, like, there's enough matches here that I don't need to show off the clips. This dude, can I show who won? There you go. This dude gave me the ass beating of a lifetime. Shoutouts to literally the king, because, now, number one, normally I wouldn't, so, last night, just to set this up, I could not sleep last night, and so I decided, alright, you know, because I haven't really played that much BlazBlue, I've had something around like 20 matches or so, let me sit down, and let me grind out some matches, and I can't record when it's late at night for a variety of reasons, and so I was playing a few matches, I got my little color, it wound up being green, I got angry, I was like, motherfucker, I think it was Suicidal Panda, who's always mocking me and making me feel bad, not really, go nuts, I love it, but said, you know, like, oh yeah, no, you can get yellow, because I was curious if you always ended up light green or if it was possible to get other colors, and they were like, oh no, man, you can get yellow, you can totally get yellow. So I was like, ah, oh, cool, man, I've won the vast majority of my matches here, surely it's about to assign me yellow, make me feel all good, warm and cuddly inside, like unicorns and rainbows are frolicking amongst the flower fields all up in my heart and shit. And instead I ended up light green, and I was like, oh, you did what? That's fucked up, man! But then, I'm curious how it works, actually, because I feel like it's like, I wonder if it kind of preemptively keeps track of the greens that you've beaten. So maybe, like, so for those of you that may not know how this color system works, you, to move up a rank, you have to get 10 more wins than losses against people of that same color. So you have to go 10-0. For instance, against other, if you are light green yourself and you're starting off with a blank slate, you have to go 10-0 against other light green players. As far as I'm aware, matches against anybody else don't count. It's only against other light green players, and then you can move up to yellow. Or for instance, if you lose like 5 matches, then you have to win 15. You just have to have 10 more wins than you have losses, and it's the exact flip or the reverse of that to move down. If you have 10 more losses than wins against people of the same color, you get knocked back a rank. And so I started out at light green, but it only took 2 matches. I only won 2 matches against another light green person, and I got moved up to yellow. So, like, I don't know if it kind of preemptively awards you a certain amount of wins against whatever color it puts you at, depending on your performance, or if it, like, keeps track. And so, like, if I had specifically gone out of my way to hunt down light green people, and I just destroyed all of them, like, it's just making me realize this system that BlazBlue has created, that Arc System Works has created, turns you into a racist genocidal maniac in order to move up the ranks, right? Like, you're light green, I'm not going after the yellows, I'm not going after the oranges, the reds, the blues. These greens are gonna get it. Now I'm yellow. Oh, these yellow motherfuckers are all gonna burn. So on and so forth. but anyway, so I don't even know why I went into this. So anyway, I got my yellow, I'm getting all feel good, like, ah, yeah, I'm fucking awesome. And then I enter a player match room, and this dude is like, oh my god, Nate, is that you? And I was like, yo, what's up, my brother? And then he handed me my ass on a silver platter. Like, the only ass beating I've had in recent memory, maybe just in memory, period, even moderately comparable to this, was against Severin in Chrono Phantasma 1.0, but that was using an incredibly overpowered version of Kokonoe that I did not know the matchup. I mean, granted, I don't know the matchup against Susanoo yet either, and I'm not comfortable with my own Susanoo, which you're gonna see. But yes, like, I did not take a single round, I believe. I'm fairly certain that I did not take a single round throughout this entire thing. Now, I'm hoping this is the match that I think it is, because what actually, it might not be, we'll see. Can I fast forward this part? Let's get rid of that. No, we want the gauge there, we want the window gone. Also, shout out to the LA Lakers, since that's the colors this dude is using. But so there was one point, I really was just getting my ass kicked nonstop. It was brutal. But the reason why I wanted to show this is just, like, this dude's actually, like, I'm gonna want to rewatch these and see, because I've mostly put it aside in my head what he's doing. But he knows a lot of things. Like, he put all of Susanoo's special moves to use. So this was not the match that I thought it was. Look at me mashing over there. My in-between round shit. Man, just look at this ass beating, man. Like, I can't get away. But this is, like, by far, this dude has the best Susanoo I have seen. Like, I haven't seen many, granted. But, like, you're always looking for high-level competition whenever you see a new character. Like, I haven't seen anybody with an S yet that's particularly good. I haven't seen anybody with a... See, that shit, I don't even know what the hell to do about that. I thought that was a shitty, stupid, useless move. That was not the match that I thought it was, by the way. I thought that was a terrible move that was just not gonna do anything worthwhile, and, like, it's actually good, and it's kind of hard to get past. Like, I'm not actually sure, how in practice, because, you know, obviously I am just ignorant. And so that was kind of, you know, the entire point of all these matches was basically that, like, I am by far the worst Susanoo. Like, there's no question about it, whereas, you know, like, this guy, very confident in his combos and his setups and his knowledge of the character. Whereas me, like, I'm struggling, I'm dropping things, I'm kind of missing certain things. And, like, he knows how to apply all of Susanoo's special moves versus me, where, like, I'm really only comfortable with, like, maybe four or five of them. Also, I'm terrible at roll catching right now. Also, see, like, right there? That was just terrible. If I was any good with the character, I would have just known, okay, he didn't tech, this 6B is landing, I then need to go into 6C. But I didn't. Also, I didn't know that's actually an overhead. I didn't know that. So I don't actually know. I guess I probably should have, like, made a note of it or something. But basically, so, like, I'm eating, I'm, like I said, I'm just eating one of the worst ass beatings I've ever had in my life from this dude. And, so eventually I'm like, alright, I need some mood music. I need something that's gonna be like, alright, it's time to put on an ass beating. And so, I turned on, ended up being Rock the Bells by LL Cool J. A good ass beating song. And then so I was kind of performing what, like, it was the best, it was, I did the best in that match than I did in any other. I actually came close to beating him versus, like, the rest of the matches, which weren't even fair. I just got bodied nonstop. It wasn't a good look for me or anybody that knows me. It was just an embarrassing moment. Right? And so but I turn on Rock the Bells, and I'm like, alright, let me take this seriously. And so Rock the Bells is going, and I do pretty well. So let me actually just show the last one. I do pretty well for myself. And then Rock the Bells ends, and it goes on to another song. I think it's called Bloodwork by Atlas. Good song. Not a fighting game, get you pumped up, in the mood, get your adrenaline flowing and wanting to kick some ass kind of song. And it just went back downhill from there. But yeah, so I don't often eat. I don't know how it would have went if I decided to pick Azrael instead. And I mean, it would have gone a hell of a lot better than what this happened, than what happened here. So, like, that right there, I actually didn't know Susanoo can kind of blow up himself. But another thing that I think I'm kind of figuring out about Susanoo through this dude's gameplay is kind of like, just be confident in the character. Just do shit, right? Because one of the big things about this character is that, like, he's using a bunch of guard breaks. He even uses Megalith at one point in time, which actually, once it's powered up, seems to be amazing for block strings because it actually guard breaks. But so, like, for instance, his 6D and his 2D are both unsafe on block, and if you block them, you can't special cancel. And so that's kind of, to me, that's kind of like, okay, I shouldn't go into these, I shouldn't use them. But I think it's kind of necessary with Susanoo. Like, you have to. Because his offense, there's no actual, the more I play him, the more I kind of realize, like, I've recently posted that other video where I come to the discovery that 2A isn't actually a low. So, like, Susanoo really doesn't have safe mix-up. It's not available to him. So you just have to, like, right there, what he's doing. You just have to be confident in your offense and that it'll work and just do it. And if it doesn't, whatever, such is life. You know, maybe you'll get another chance, maybe you didn't. But you can't try to play safe and succeed at the same time, I think, is kind of what, I'm not sure which is the last one I played. But so that's kind of what I've gathered from him. And I kind of wish that I had been able to, because I found him in another lobby that was like, there were like six people in there, but everybody aside from me, I guess, and him were auto-passing. Like, I don't know if he had just handed everybody their ass so many times they were just like, ah, fuck it, I'm just gonna auto-pass now. This dude's a really good player. Definitely one of the, like, seems to be one of the best players I've ever played. But again, with me being fairly ignorant with Susanoo, it's a little hard to judge that. Like, I'm not very confident in my Susanoo. I miss a lot of things. I'm still working on under, let me just pause it real quick so I can kind of talk about it. So, like, for instance, one of the things that I've never really had to deal with, that I am actually having to deal with a lot more now thanks to Tager, not being able to just kind of freeform your normals, right? Like, there are certain normals that you absolutely cannot cancel into other normals from. I'm not used to that. So, like, for instance, with Tager, when I'm playing that dude, there are still occasions where I try to do 6A3C, but it doesn't work. That game does not allow it anymore, and so it forces 6A2C. Something with Susanoo, I need to figure out exactly what you can cancel from 5C. I know you can cancel into 5D and 2C, but, like, I know for a fact you cannot cancel from 5C into either 6D or 2D. I do not believe you can cancel into 3C. Obviously, you can't go backwards into B moves or A moves, and it is special cancelable. But so, like, it's kind of like that, where a lot of the times, like, I recognize that I put somebody in a block string and now they're out of range of 5C. Not 5C, they're out of range of 2C, because it moves him forward a little bit whenever you use it, but it doesn't have a very large horizontal hitbox. It's very much upward and kind of around Susanoo in general. It doesn't really move sideways very much. And so, because of that, a lot of times I try to just be like, okay, this 2C will not hit them. Let me just go straight into either 6D or 2D or 3C. And then I don't get any of those moves, and it kind of throws me for a bit of a loop, kind of kills my mentality for a second. And so, like, getting accustomed to that and knowing intrinsically, okay, I cannot do that anymore. Also, he uses 6B a ton, and it's a tool that I've recognized I need to use more of, and that I really don't use at the moment, which is really, really bad for me. I mean, obviously, you know, you have all of his special moves that I haven't really put into use very much either. But so it's just kind of like, you know, the huge comparison between, like, somebody who is confident in their abilities with the character versus me, where, like, I don't know what's safe and what isn't. I don't know what gaps are where. I don't know what properties special moves have. Like, I was actually surprised that, like, it's okay, so here's the part where he really starts abusing Megalith. I knew that a guard broke. I didn't know that you would be able to combo off this. I also did not know that 214B is actually an overhead. I didn't know that. And so then that was just a reset. Like, this is just, like I said, it's just constant ass beatings from this dude. And I want to show them off because, like, I mean, number one, I'm never embarrassed by a loss that I get. It's part of fighting games. You're going to lose. Some of them are going to look kind of bad. You know, like, you kind of look back at them like, why did I lose that? Not these matches. I know exactly why the fuck I lost these matches. But I've never understood why there are, like, so many people who do post things and are like, they purposefully edit them out so that you don't see them lose. Which is just like, what? It's not a shameful thing to lose. Nobody's gonna judge you for lose. Well, some people do judge people for losing, but like, nobody that's worth having around is gonna judge you for losing. They understand that's a part of fighting games. And I also need to note that down, that you can actually just go straight, because that's a problem I've actually been having with certain hit confirms, where like, I get the launch of it, and then I try to do either, you know, like JB or JC, and then they tech out in between the JB and JC, and so then I can't land that JD, so I need to kind of remember in the back of my head that I can do certain things that force a launch, and then I can immediately JD afterwards. Because, I mean, like, I really do need to kind of just sit back and learn from these, because this is a good Susanoo player, and I am very much not. And it's not often that you get to see, like, a really good player. And so that's kind of why I wanted to, that's why I started saving these. See, like, right there. He knows the timing to destroy me. I sure as shit didn't. But like right there, that would have been an excellent time to just go into a high. But the problem is that like, once you kind of understand Susanoo, there's not that significant of a reason to just not block high. Because nobody's going to go straight into one of his lows. Like, nobody's going to start a block string with 3C. Or, this would also reset. Yeah, like, look, it's standing resets me. I think he might have actually been able to do a combo from that. I'm not sure. Also, I really need to stop letting people roll. I'm terrible at that right now. Was that Pokemon Sun? Or no, I got Pokemon Moon. That might be. I'm actually gonna pause this and go see if I can get it. It was just a newspaper. I don't understand it. That was really weird. That's never happened before. I just realized this dude has instant blocks too. Also, look how punishable that was. Holy crap. You cannot just let it, because that's a big thing. Like I mentioned, I kind of like, I try to cancel from 5C into things, and then sometimes it just doesn't work. And like, his 5C is the worst move to leave out to whiff, or you know, like not to follow up with anything. It's just, it is not a good move. Seriously, look at this dude, look at the ass beatings he's giving me. I actually don't think we've seen a perfect, but he got a lot of perfects on me. I actually don't know how long was that first video, because I may just show all the ones off that I recorded. I'm not going to bother trying to go into the ones that like, 17 minutes, yeah. Plenty of time to show off that stuff. Don't have to bother with the video clips, because those are more annoying to use in the replays. But yeah, I need to start using 6B so much, because I couldn't figure out how to handle it. I really didn't know what to do about it. And so obviously, if I can't figure out how to use it, clearly I should start using it. It was such like, it's such bad progression on my part. It's like that, I didn't know that worked. I didn't know you could do one hit of 6B and then cancel into 6D, and that's something that's good to know. Because if you had tried to do, like, for instance, you can do both hits of 6B and cancel that into 6D, but at that point in the combo, it would have dropped. But you just do one hit into 6D, you get a knockdown, and you can special cancel it into something, stuff like that. Like, it's that kind of stuff that really is. It's like right there, I should have canceled it into 6D, but I didn't. And I fucked up everything. Lost my chance at momentum. I I should have watched some of this. Occurring to me that I should have watched some of these beforehand, and then so I could like point out specific special things. Cause I'm kind of like, I'm just kind of watching them and enjoying them right now. Cause like I said, like this is a good Susanoo, and it's fun to watch people that are just good with their characters, certain characters that I like. If he was a good 9, I wouldn't give a shit. Sorry, 9 players. But see, like, he actually uses all of Susanoo's special moves. Like, the only one that I think, after seeing all of this, the only one that I actually think still might be useless is the C-mashing one, the little ball. I'm not 100% on it. It might be useful depending on how hard it actually is to get around. But it seems kind of like one of those things where it'll blow up somebody who's ignorant of it, i.e. me. But once you know how to kind of get past it and not get blown up by it. Also, I need to stop making my approaches so obvious. Like, I really realize that it's kind of just like, I'll jump, I'll hang in the air a little bit, and then I'll dash forward, and it's kind of like, I give them all the time in the world to understand that I'm in the air, and I might come in, so prepare an anti-air, you know? And so that is a big problem with me, with my Susanoo, is that I don't have good approaches right now. And part of that is just because his forward dash is like, I mean, oops, I mentioned, god damn it, what am I doing? What button am I? There we go. I want to fast forward. Because his forward dash, like, you know, you want to talk about something that warns somebody. His forward dash has a half second starting animation before you actually start moving forward. So they know when you're going to dash forward. And also that right there, so like you saw, I landed that 60, but then I didn't special cancel it. And so the problem is that like, you should always special cancel that, just on the off chance that it might hit, because if it doesn't hit, you don't get the special cancel anyway. If it hits, then obviously it confirms into something. Also, I really feel like they should fix the, see, there was my another, I'm so bad at roll catching right now. See, right there, I'm like, okay, what do I do about this? Surely I can hit him through it. No. But I'm really bad with roll catching. Like, that's one of the things that I'm the worst at overall with this character so far. I mean, I'm bad at everything with him so far. But, especially roll catching. Like, you can't let, this character's neutral is not good enough to allow people to just get away for free. Like, is this another one where it just resets me? No, it just stopped doing damage even though it kept hitting me for like 30 extra hits. There you go, there's one of the perfects. But there really are, there's so many things that I need to get accustomed to again in this game. So like reacting to guard crushes and not getting hit by them. Because like just giving people free combos is inexcusable. Overheads in general, obviously. But this was the first time I played him where it was really like, oh shit, this is real. And my anti-air timing needs to be significantly better. Like, it just, I am so bad. I wonder how safe that actually is. Oh, right, because the original lobby I was in was best of 5 instead of best of 3. So I get 3 rounds of getting my ass kicked in this one. Yay! But it does look like overall... his 6D is far more unsafe than 2D. The thing, I think off of that rapid cancel, I would have been able to use his 214D and actually gotten a legit combo off of it. But at that point, I mean, like, until I played this dude, I did not realize how good 214B actually was for combos. I really didn't. I didn't know, well, there was actually, it's largely a part of, because it's something, like, I filed away, but I haven't really put into practice yet. Susanoo has standing-specific combos, where his 6D causes a crumple against a standing opponent, or, like, against a non-prone opponent or airborne opponent. And so that gives you enough time to land a 214D and then juggle from that. But it's something I haven't really put into practice yet because it does only work against standing opponents. Because when they're crouching, that actually the animation... it's kind of like if you've ever dealt with Bang's 5C, where he starts with like his hand behind his head, and it actually has a hitbox that entire time. I don't know why he would wrap it there, though. Like, why wouldn't he just do... why wouldn't you just do 236, 236D? I don't know. What's this other one? Oh, that's right. I went and I downloaded. I went to, where is it? You come over here, and you can go look at... Is it ranking list? Yeah, replay board. And I just, like, I went through and I looked at characters that were available and anything that I saw that might look good. Let's check this out. A level 33 Susanoo. And a level 32 Noelle. I'm sure people are curious what a good Noelle looks like. You know the part that pisses me off the most? I mean, I'll get there in a bit. So, when I did this, I downloaded a bunch of them. And, like, half of them just said, like, you are not allowed to replay. Let's check out an Essen and Azreal. Why not? You are not allowed to replay this replay. And it's like, what the fuck? Why? Then why is it available for download if I can't even fucking play it? You asswipe. Okay, an S and a Susanoo. This is the replay day. I might try to do this a bit more, because it's kind of... it's fun to just sit back and watch characters that you're interested in. And that you have no stake in. Oh god, a 43% win ratio. Don't be judgmental! You probably have less than that now after you just lost like 30 matches. What's the highest level, by the way? I think the highest I've seen is 32. Oh, wait, no, we just saw 33, right? Yeah, there's a 33. So it's probably 35, I would assume. Because if it was 40, I'm sure we'd be seeing people above that. I stopped looking at characters, and now I'm only looking at the levels. So who knows what I just bypassed. 88% win ratio. This person is either a rage quitter or fucking oh, monster. You think that's the pro? I know monsters are really, really good because that says monster Ragna. I know monster is a very, very good professional Ragna player, so that makes sense. Because that's kind of what, you know, like the top tier people tend to have. Win ratios, like, let's actually, I want to watch that one first. Granted, it's not Ragna, it is Hakumen.
The wheel of fate is turning. Rebel, one, action!
Ballsy as hell to start with that. Well, not really, actually, because I think that is safe on block, right? Certainly looks safe. That can't possibly... that was working? Off of 3 2As? this work. This can't work. That works off of 3 2-A's? Is it just 5-A that murders the dude? Because, like, there are certain combos that, like, you can't even combo into 5-D from them. Man, this dude has not had any meter the entire time. I guess it doesn't matter because I'm winning it. Nice setup. Call hit the fuck out. See, like, what this dude's doing is something that I've kind of recognized I need to be a lot more aware of. He keeps... You never want to hit a D move when that's just going to progress the meter, when it's not going to unlock something, because then it's kind of wasted, right? And so, like, being able to just adjust your combos on the fly to account for stuff like that, I think is really, really important for the character. And that's something that I need to work on myself. Nice. No! Okay. I'm gonna say, like, off of that starter, come on. Ooh, get fucked! So definitely not as good as the Ragna. If that is indeed monster. See, this shit, why do you let it be? Why is it downloadable then? Oh, it's probably gonna be the same thing. Why would, okay, maybe it's not. Because I know there is a setting, right, where you can make it so it's like, can these replays be saved? I know there's a setting for something like that. And so I assume one of the people has to have that enabled or disabled so, like, you can't view the replays. But then why do you allow them to be downloaded in the first place if you can't view them? Oh god, my, please instant block. For the love of god, please instant block. Call them the fuck out. Oh, thank god her exceed excel. You know, everybody complains, everybody wants to say shit about Mai for one reason or another, but thank god her exceed excel animation isn't like 17 seconds long. Kokonoe's bullshit? Holy crap, that needs to go. They need to figure out something else. Oh, come on! Fucking round start DP and he gets away with it. Oh no. This Mai is so, like, all that I can just see how scared this Mai is. Yeah, she dead now. Oh, yeah, Astral. Ouch. It just sucks when you, cause, like, that's one of, it's so, obviously, like, I play Asriel, right? I know how hard it is to fight that dude, especially online, but, like, the worst thing you can do against Asriel is play scared against him. Which sounds so unintuitive because he is so fucking dangerous. But it's kind of the same thing with Tager. You kind of have to, because they expect you to kind of just, like, well, not, they don't expect you, but a pretty decent amount of their offense kind of relies upon disrespecting you and allowing you, like, stuff like that. And you kind of allowing it to happen. And so when you do, he seems so much worse than he actually is. because there are so many people who are like, oh my god, this character is so scary, and then they just let him get away with murder, and then he murders you. And so then your fears are kind of justified, right? But it's the best way you can fight him is to try to bully him back instead of letting him bully you. That's another big part. Being able to recognize the starting animation of his. What the hell was that? This dude's Valiant Charge combos are worse than mine. being able to recognize when he's that, like the start, because you can't react to him ending up on the other side of you. It's too fast at that point. You gotta be able to react to the startup of his dash and understand he's gonna go through you. Oh, is he dead? My, no! My, you poor woman. As much as people complain about Mai, all I've ever really seen is her getting the shit kicked out of her. The wheel of fate is turning. That's a terrible idea against S. That is just a bad, bad idea against S. I learned that. Because there's so much whiff recovery on it that she can... She has the range on her sword that, I mean, unless she's, like, completely full screen, she can whiff punish you. Never actually seen anybody do that. Not use JC at all, just JB, JB, JD. It's kind of weird when you're watching both players play scared. Because both of them are very, like, look at all these gaps in between. I shouldn't really say scared. But, like, there's some sort of nerves involved. Whether it's uncomfortableness with the character, which obviously I can recognize very well in Susanoo, given that I am very intimate with all the signs of them, given I can just watch replays of myself. But then you just see, like, these strange gaps that, like, it's not a frame trap. It wasn't meant as anything. Like, something very clearly went wrong. And they didn't really know how to handle it, so they just kind of froze for a half second. Did 6A just clash with that? Did I just see that correctly? Like, 6A clashed with the distortion and nullified the hitbox of it? Because that just went straight through Susanoo. I'm fairly certain. Like, is there like a fucking... Hang on. Pause this. Never mind, I can't pause it. Is there like a rewind? There's not a rewind. But yeah, like, I'm pretty sure he didn't block anything. It just went through him. And he threw out a 6A. So, like, that's a really bad projectile if that's the case. Might have been able to kill off of that if he hadn't used the crush counter and used a distortion instead. Maybe not, because part of the damage of his main distortion is based on... Because it changes. I feel so sorry for people who don't know like how bad of a move 6A actually is. There's so much recovery to it. It doesn't... Fuck you. It doesn't... The one that I was actually looking forward to, the level 31 or whatever, Noel, and I can't fucking, you suck. Well, anyway, but yeah, like, 6A is just, you can kind of basically normal jump over it without too much of a problem. The amount of whiff recovery it has is absurd, and a lot of characters can punish it, even from full screen, with certain tools. And even if, like, you block it and they cancel it into 4D, so they get a little power-up, even 4D has a pretty significant amount of recovery to it, so you gotta learn. That's something you should probably kind of set up in training mode and just have the AI spam it on you and just figure out ways for your character to get around it, because it has a surprising amount of recovery. A lot of Susanoo's moves do. And so if you can make him whiff pretty much anything, like, it's basically game on for you. You can do whatever the fuck you want at that point. But anyway, I have exhausted my supply of replays. Hope you enjoyed King's fantastic Susanoo. I know I did, even though I was on the tail end of the ass beating of a lifetime. Thank you for watching. See y'all next time.